What up, everybody? Welcome to another video. And today we're going to be discussing about my USMNT 26 man squad for the September camp. Alright, so let's begin. So, the USMNT will be playing their final two matches before going into the World Cup. So, yeah, obviously, this camp is going to be very important. Obviously, the USMNT are going to be facing Japan and Saudi Arabia, which are two sides that are on paper we should be able to beat. However, they are kind of like simulations for Iran, since both of those teams do play in the Asian division in the Asiatic Confederation. So yeah, obviously they kind of do simulate Iran, especially Saudi Arabia. So yeah, let's begin. So obviously this camp is going to be very important. So yeah, Greg is going to have to bring a good roster, and he's going to have to bring some good faces that are some decent players that are informed that probably haven't gotten enough looks. So yeah, let's get into this. So let's start off with the goalkeepers. So for me, the goalkeepers will have to be Matt Turner, Zach Steffen, and Ethan Horvath. Okay, so Zach Steffen is our starting goalkeeper, and he should probably be given as many minutes as possible. He hasn't been the best for Nottingham Forest, and I wish he can at least go back into form, get some good form in before going into these matches, because he's gonna really need it. Matt Turner, we haven't really seen much from him, but hopefully he has been improving a lot with Mikel Arteta. And with Ethan Horvath, obviously he's been pretty good with Luton Town. He's been pretty average, pretty above average. However, obviously these three goalkeepers have been pretty good. I'm hoping that at least one of them takes their game up to a new level, because obviously we're gonna be needing it during the World Cup. So yeah. Next is the center backs: Chris Richards, Cameron Carter-Vickers, Walker Zimmerman, Mark McKenzie, and James Sands. So no Aaron Long. So yeah, obviously that's gonna be one of the most obvious things. The only MLS guy I would only choose is probably Walker Zimmerman, because Walker Zimmerman has been in form with the USMNT when he's playing. So yeah, Chris Richards obviously has been pretty good when he has been getting chances with Crystal Palace. Obviously Cameron Carter-Vickers, he has been pretty good with Celtic, and obviously he'll be playing in Champions League pretty soon, so that should be pretty exciting as well. Mark McKenzie, now that Lukumi, the other starting center back for Genk, is gone, obviously Mark McKenzie will not be the starting center back at Genk. So yeah, that's gonna be really exciting to see. And James Sands, he just helped Rangers get into the Champions League. So obviously, yeah, obviously James Sands can play multiple positions, which he's a pretty versatile player, and that's going to be very important to have in the World Cup, because having versatile players is going to be really important because of injuries and COVID as well. So yeah. Fullbacks. Anthony Robinson, Jedi, will be one of the left backs I will bring. Sam Vines has been pretty good for Royal Antwerp, and I would bring him because he has been pretty good with Royal Antwerp. Sergio Dest, although he hasn't played much with Barcelona, I hope he leaves Barcelona, but he's still probably our best fullback. And Joe Scully, I would bring him as well, because he's been in form with Borussia Mönchengladbach. So obviously no DeAndre Yedlin for this, so yeah. Would I bring DeAndre Yedlin for the World Cup? Probably not, because that's going to be a waste of a roster spot. DeAndre Yedlin has not been that good with Inter Miami, to be honest. And there have been better fullbacks in MLS, better American fullbacks in MLS than DeAndre Yedlin. So yeah. Next is the midfielders. Weston McKennie from Juventus. Obviously, we're going to have to bring him. Yunus Musa, again, another player that we're going to have to bring as well. Both of them are probably going to be our starting eights for the World Cup. Obviously, Brendan Aaronson is going to have a big say in this, because obviously Brendan Aaronson has been in form of Leeds. Luca De La Torre hopefully starts getting a little bit more minutes for Celta de Vigo. Tyler Adams, he has been really good for Leeds, and he has been a boss in the CDM, and I hope he can perform like that for us. Kellen Lacasa, I'll probably put him as our backup six. And Alex Mendes, I would bring Alex Mendes to this camp, because he has been pretty good with Vizela, and obviously he's one of the most crucial dual nationals, and obviously since he's not injured, I would bring Alex Mendez to this camp for the September camp. So yeah, obviously this is going to be a really good midfield group. So yeah. Next week we'll be going into the wingers, Christian Pulisic from Chelsea. Obviously he hasn't played much for Chelsea, but obviously he's still one of our top three best players. Malik Tillman, in form of Rangers, and he has helped them get into the Champions League, which is very important. Timothy Weah, he'll be coming back from injury pretty soon, so obviously I would pick Timothy Weah for this camp if he's healthy. Dejordan Mihailovic, I would pick him as a winger, because obviously we need wingers in this depth chart for crying out loud. He just transferred to AZ Alkmaar, and I'm very excited to see what he can do in the Eredivisie and the Netherlands with them. So yeah, I'm very very excited to see what he can do. So now let's go to the strikers. So the strikers for me, I would bring is Jordan Pefok. He has been in form. And what I mean by in form, I mean he has been scoring goals in the Bundesliga. And he has been doing it in the Bundesliga. Not in the Swiss Bundesliga, but in the Bundesliga. So now he has transformed his game to the new level. So yeah, it's very good to see. Folarin Balogun. Obviously, I would pick him. He has been pretty good for Rhyme so far, and he has been playing as a lone striker. So that's something very good to see. He can probably fit into our system really good. I've seen Folarin Balogun play, and I'm excited to see if Greg does pick him up, and if Yunus Musa can help us recruit him. So yeah, Josh Sargent scoring goals in the championship. Obviously, you want something better than a championship striker, but Josh Sargent, obviously, he has been scoring goals in the championship. He's been scoring goals again. So hopefully, he can carry that form into the September camp if he can do it. So yeah, obviously, this is going to be a very, 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 very interesting one to see what Greg does choose, because there's been a number of players that have gotten in form. So I'm excited to see what Greg decides to choose. Obviously, with strikers, you can bring anybody. I wouldn't be against picking Jesus Ferreira, since he's been playing the most minutes with us. You can pick Brandon Vasquez. You can pick Oswald Haji Wright. So there's a number of players you can pick. So yeah, thank you guys for watching. We'll see you guys in the next video. Adios. Bye-bye. Thank you guys for watching. Goodbye.